And well, as you can see, the first map, or rather the first map of this session, is going to be Fairrivers, because that's a preset map, and it looks something like this. Okay, so that's a lot of fish all around. It's basically like normal rivers with kind of fair distribution of absolutely everything. You can see that there are not any kind of problems on either corners or even either sides. So wherever the players decide to place their docks, they should be pretty much fine. And it's all about proper walling to basically cover all those choke points and travel points between those two islands, and yeah, literally between any islands in the game here. Looking at the civilizations, we have NC Pedro as Viking, Andorin is Han, Sniper is Mongol, and against them we have almost a proper mirage as a switch between Huns and Mayans. We have Spaden as Mongol, then we have Bullet as Viking, and Beta is Mayan. Okay, so that's quite interesting, so let's have a look around how the players will approach this map. Let's have a look, for example, on Beite, who is MBL, and so far he's having kind of interesting placement of the mines. This is pretty much safe, but this one is slightly unfortunate, both because it's kind of close to the water, so it could be targetable in Castle Age, Imperial Age for sure, but what's more important, that it is actually half blocked by the woods from the bottom, which is usually not ideal, and if you want to have a lot of gold miners on here, yeah, this is definitely not what you want to see. But fortunately for him, he does have the second gold mine, so it shouldn't be really all that much of a problem. Bit of a boar in here on the right, and I think the second one, oh, that was a wolfie. Okay, second one is at the bottom, so not any kind of problem, already aiming for it, and he's actually stealing all these stealing boars. Yeah, he actually is, and that seems like a double boar steal from Sniper, but if that is actually true, that's absolutely brutal. I'm just going to check with Sniper. He's right now just finishing with the sheep, going for the deer. And yes, yes, it's actually a successful double steal. Well, that's a pretty big problem for NCs and pretty huge help for MBL and RFR altogether. And well, this is damn well played. So pretty good job by Sniper. Or rather, well, not very good job by him, but rather by MBL. And wow, that's a very interesting start to this game, and it might be even decided before the game even started, because losing both of those boars is going to put you down quite a lot, and I'm not exactly sure how Sniper hopes to fight against MBL. But at the same time, this is a map that is basically made all about the choke point, so if he can defend the choke point, he can still make something happen, especially with the help from his teammates. Otherwise, the base of Pedro is looking quite nice with the relic in here, the gold placement. Yeah, not really a nice toe placement. It's yet again in the woods in here, so not ideal at all. But otherwise, seems pretty much okay for him, and I don't see any kind of problems with that. For example, let's switch into Bullet right now, who is going for one of his boars that is at the bottom. Also, yeah, kind of sucky placement of the gold mines. But not really all that bad, as we could have seen with the stone for Pedro. And otherwise, both stones pretty much fine, so I don't really think this is going to be all that much of a problem. The red player is going to be the next, as Spaden. He's right now having a bit of a meeting between Andorin Scout and Bullet Scout, so that's quite a lot of scouting going on the Red Island, of course, with his own Scouty, and just finishing the dock at pretty interesting placement. That's a very aggressive one, and he will be definitely hoping that he can deny some kind of fish gathering from Andorin, which is, of course, going to be quite important on this map. Andorin is already having this, the boats here, already on pretty much a good spot. On the right, we see that Pedro is having a look at him, and maybe he was hoping that he could actually steal one of the boars back, at least one of them. But yeah, that's not going to happen, and really, Beta is going to be having so much food, so much extra food, as opposed to his opponent, Yellow. So let's have a look how he's doing. Fortunately for him, he's having quite a lot of sheep, and I would be thinking that maybe even Pedro is sending a bit to him, because they definitely needed to communicate about that. He has already butchered quite a lot of deer in here. So far, it's not really much of a problem for him, but really, this will escalate, as double boar steal is, of course, always pretty great. The last to have a look at is Andorin on his home base. Stone and gold, pretty nice positions, not really any kind of problem. Stone number 2, 3, and really, all those mines are pretty nice, so not any kind of problem. Let's just turn off the chat so that we don't potentially get any kind of spoilers. And let's have a look around for the dock placement. Well, Pedro has opted for a bit of a defensive one, as opposed to Bullet at the bottom. You can see that Bullet is having It's not really offensive, but it's definitely not defensive. It's one basically to help his allies in the battle and wherever he needs, so that's a pretty good idea. And of course, this really tells you that our Fars are right now feeling very strong and that they could definitely make something happen in here. Wait, he's trying to finish with the Volin. And Sniper, well, he didn't really want to catch his heavy scout caught in here, or does he? Yeah, he does. I thought it was pretty good idea to actually have the scout on the opponent's ground, because obviously, once he does have him there, he can scout what his opponent is doing, how fast he's advancing, if he's jumping into castle or whatever, and well, this is definitely going to help him in making sure that he can properly defend against what MBL is going to do against him. Privilege is out reclining with yet another defensive placement of the dog by Sniper. Yeah, right now going for even the second dog right here, with MBL having a dog on the right side, so yeah, this is pretty much a similar position as for Bullet in the middle, and they are kinda halfway there, but not really, so kinda interesting placement, and we are seeing that one of the scouts has paid with his life, and it seems like a red one, so that's paid him without a scout. And well, this is kinda interesting. This reminds me of the first Fairy Wars that were between BYT and Vix, and it developed into a pretty big problem for Vix. And that's no walling in here. Lavihead didn't really wall on the map, which allowed quite a heavy raiding from Tatoch, and that definitely led to big problems for Vix overall, and they did have problems with defending against that. And right now it's really seeming like the same thing in here. And Spaden should definitely be careful. He's already sent the Willy in. But Pedro, together with Andoremi, trying to basically stop him. But with Loom, that's not going to be all that easy. And yeah, he's at least trying to do this with the Stonewall, but does he have some kind of reinforcements? Unfortunately not. So the wall will be finished, so not any kind of lasting problems. But let's have a look on the water, where we see a bit of a gully rushing from both Green and Spaden. Okay, so that's interesting. And so far on the numbers, it's pretty much equal, and it's probably going to be equal for quite some time. Three docks in here, three docks in here. So really, not any kind of problem. Looking at the civilizations, it's Han against Mongol. Oh, yeah, it's not really anything that should be decided right there. And we also see a bit of interesting stuff on the right side. And that sniper, sorry. Sniper basically trying to finish with the walling, because he's recognizing that he needs to defend as much as he can. Because right now, with a very heavy start, he's going to be under attack on the water, which he already is. And since he's a bit behind, looking at the villager count, 27 and 29 for Beta. Yeah, that's a bit of a difference right there. Even though on the fishing boats, Sniper is having 4 more, so not really any kind of problem in there. But still, he needs to be careful, because MBL will be up quite faster, and quite potentially will be having an easier time pushing on his opponent. Already going through Blacksmith, so yeah, he will be jumping into Castle Age very soon. Switching to his point of view. So far not there with the resources, but that's not really kind of important indicator right now, because obviously that's going to happen in just a matter of moments. Otherwise, a lot of gold being gathered by Sniper. And market being built by Pedro. Okay, so he's marketing in here. He's having 28 villagers, so that's a pretty strong echo. And since he is a Viking, he might actually be slinging if he hopes that land aggression is going to be what's deciding this game. But well, we're going to have to wait and see once the players advance into Castle Age what the real plans for everybody are. Finishing with the Stonewalling as well for Andorin. Whereas on here, red is already finished. But I'm kinda curious, why didn't he actually wall about here? Because that would definitely help him. As right now Andorin, or rather Pedro, will be having slightly easier time advancing into the middle if he wants to go for aggression. So yeah, that's a bit better map control for NC so far. So let's see if that's going to be something that will change the game around. Blacksmith being built by Sniper, and well, bit of a wolfy fight, but since he had Loom, wasn't really all that much of a problem. And MBL doesn't have all that many boats, so that he could actually take down the navy from yellow all that much, especially when he's fighting very far away from his home base. And well, this basically means that Sniper should be defending without any kind of problem. But well, Let's have a look on the left. Pretty much equal numbers still. Slightly favoring Andorin maybe. So with proper micro he could be just good to go in there. But looking also at the gas leeches, we have Bullet and Pedro, both pockets. Both Vikings advancing into the next age, so not any kind of slinging, and really, they will be just aiming potentially to own the water for their teams, and... Well, that could be just as it, because if you control water on this map, it's definitely helping you in preventing any kind of landing, and also helping you in actually making the landings happen on some unexpected parts of the map, and yeah, it's really making quite a lot of difference if you can control the water here. Blue Scout trapped in red base, it's not really all that much of a problem, it's actually a bonus. The same could be said for Sniper, who are basically having a very nice way of seeing what is happening in their opponent's bases. Same could be said for Bullet right now from RFR, and well, he's actually trying to raid his opponent, but that's not going to work all that much, because obviously, those villagers are almost as strong as the Scout. Of communication problems on there, on the left, as you could have seen. And we see Castle Age for Pedro being finished, and Bullet is already going for Cartography and Bowsaw. So he's definitely going for quite a lot of water, and let's see if he's going to switch into some army very soon. So far he isn't having all that much of it. Just a bit right now, preparing for the War Galleys potentially. And well, Pedro seems to be doing basically the same. He's having a dock at the bottom, if I see this correctly. Oh no, this is just a house, sorry. Does he have some kind of dock somewhere? No, he doesn't. So he's having dock just at the top, so he's having quite a long walk, or rather sail, for all of those boats to get to the battlefield, which is not ideal. And right now he's going to be caught in a pretty bad spot. And yeah, that's just some cheap shots for Spaden. And really, Pedro should be doing a bit better, as right now he's going to be fighting at two spots at once, because he did have one of the galleys at the very bottom, which is pretty much dead, I think. Already, as he has encountered some boats from purple. And looking at the amount of boats right now from Beite, who has switched to the middle, he seems to be joining with Bullet right now, and this is going to be a lot of problems for Pedro, because right now he will be fighting just alone. And you can kind of see where this is going right now. Just about for Sniper finishing this wall, which is pretty important, as obviously without that, Spaden could be potentially going onto his island without any kind of opposition. But still, this is a weak spot, and he needs to be careful about that. And right now he could be able to finish. He actually dares to, but doesn't seem like that he does there. And the water battle on the left seems to be going for Andorin quite strongly, as Spaden is basically just waiting for the help of his ally Bullet, who is arriving slowly but surely. And once he does arrive in full strength, well, I don't really envy the position of Andorin, as he will be facing quite a bit of a problem with the War Galleys in there. Vader also advancing into the Castle Age. With a bit of a water battle in the middle, and RFRs definitely seem to be controlling the middle of the map. On the left, Andorin might be winning, but that's just kind of short-lived victory, I would be saying, rather thinking, because Bullet is right now joining with Red, and this should be more than enough to deal with the problem that Andorin is right now for RFR. Vader also switching to the left, having a pretty nice view of the island and of all the outposts of Andorin. Whereas on the right, we can see that Sniper is not really going anywhere all that much with his boats. Just in the middle here, he's moving all his navy into the middle, as definitely they are recognizing that they need all the boats in there. And yeah, this is going to be quite important. Right now I'm kind of thinking that this patch of the map is going to be super important for the next progress of the game, because if somebody is able to place a castle here, it would definitely secure the whole middle. And there are some crucial shallows like this one and this one, and really, that would help quite a lot of to either teams that decide to go for the earlier aggression on land. Andorin right now has to be super careful, as he's facing all three guys, Spaden, Bait and Bullet at one spot, so he definitely doesn't have enough for that. And well, since he's advancing into Castle Age right now, he will be with four guys quite soon, but not sooner than Bait. Reinforcements from Bullet, with Pedro sending some boats from the bottom. He should be probably sending them also to the top. Right now he's sending them all to the middle. which is not really ideal, as he definitely needs to help at the left side, because yeah, there are all three RFRs at one spot, and if they could corner them somewhere, it could actually be taking a pretty good battle. Sniper, come on, to the top. Yeah, right now he's going there, so that's going to be a pretty good placement. It's going to actually turn into a pretty nice battle. Especially, oh. I'm just right now looking at the War Galley upgrade for Sniper, and just kind of unfortunate timing right now for NCs, I would say. Because if they would wait a bit longer before the War Galleys and Vodkin arrows were actually researched, I think they would have won very easily the battle, but right now they seem to be winning anyway, because Andorin has joined from the top, and they are basically fighting a very nice battle right now, and RFRs are going to lose quite a lot of boats, and it might be quite easily game-changing in here, because so far it seemed like that RFRs were having a strong upper hand, but right now that's basically nullified. And since Bullet is having to send reinforcements from all across the map, it's not going to be as efficient as the army that is right now and on the spot. So pretty much Spaden is going to lose everything in here, I think, very soon. Whereas at the top, it seems like that Sniper is in a bit of a pickle, as he's facing quite a lot of boats from Beta, who has sent a second half of his army to the right. Is a pretty good idea, but still he's fighting right next to the dogs of his opponent, so with some proper micro and potentially some bit of help from Pedro, he might be quite good and ready to advance on his opponent as well. Yeah, Pedro is already sending some units in, but it should be pretty much okayish battle for NCs against RFRs. And well, left, it's kind of as we predicted, but with yellow somehow inexplicably retreating. Pedro is right now losing quite a lot of boats without any kind of effect, which is pretty sad. And Andorin just needs to wait for the war galleys of himself. He is in the castle age, but so far doesn't have the resources. And this is tough miscommunication by NCs. Here you can see that Pedro is retreating with everything. Andorin is not on spot yet, and this is bad battle for a sniper. Even though he's winning, he definitely should have waited for Andorin, because it would have been quite a lot better for him. And well, not exactly sure what is going on right now for NC team. At the top, Beta is still dealing quite a substantial amount of damage to the navies of Sniper and Pedro, with Pedro not really being in here so far. Just one boat in here, with pretty much the brunt of the battle for NCs being on Sniper's back. Looking at how those boats are kinda half dead, might not actually be all that hard for Sniper to deal with this, as obviously there won't be any kind of replacements for Beta, and you don't really see them on the minimap either, just having quite a lot of boats near his home base, and it's going to take quite some time before they sail all the way around the island to the main battlefield in here. On the left, yeah, we just see a Sniper advancing onto his opponent, that's pretty much it, and well, on the land, doesn't seem like that there's much happening so far. Just having a look around the map once the players were paused, and we are seeing 1-2 TCs for yellow so far. Yeah, it seems so. 2 TCs for yellow, whereas MBL is having just one TC, so that's a proper water battle for him. Doesn't have any kind of extras in here, and he has already lost the navy here at the very top, because Blue has retreated, or rather returned, with all the reinforcements that he needed, and yeah, this was a pretty good job, and also the reason why Beta was staying at his home base, as he recognized that he won't really win the battle, and yeah, this is very, very well played on the right by NCs, and they could be going into full offensive on their opponent, because with this amount of boats, they definitely are having a lot more than just MBL. On the left, Andorin has finally joined in the battle with Sniper, so even though Sniper has lost a substantial amount of boats of his own, it right now seems to be pretty much in NC's hands, and looking how there are not really all that many reinforcements from Bullet or literally anyone from RFR, it almost seems like that NC's have won the water. But let's not really call it a day yet, because it's going to take quite some time, and let's see if somebody is switching actually into the land battle. So far, the victory of the water is definitely paying the dividends for NCs, as Pedro is able to rate a bit of a gold release on here, which which is definitely valuable. And of course, if they advance into the Imperial Age, like Pedro is right now, that's a pretty fast one. Actually being slung by someone. No, just bullet is slinging into Spaden. Okay, that's also interesting to see. With Spaden being the Mongol and having, well, quite a lot of town centers, 40 Cs right now. With Kasse being built in pretty important spot, that's very close to the shoreline, which is one important spot, and also close to the shallows, so he will have some kind of control over this stone and also about this part of the map. So that's a pretty nice placement. But on the water, they are definitely toast. And I don't really think they could be coming back or even wanted to come back, because it would be pretty expensive. And looking at the amount of boats from absolutely everybody of NCs, I'm not really thinking they're going to be taking some nice battle for them. Spaden advancing into Imperial Age, but Pedro having already galleons and chemistry underway. So I don't really expect this battle to go all that well for MBL. Let's just wait for the galleons to arrive on the battle scene. And yep, here we go. And it should be a pretty easy battle and pretty much utter destruction of Beta's navy. He's having just a few of them. Those galleons are definitely doing their job quite nicely. It's 8 plus 3 against just 7 plus 2, so that's a huge difference. And also in the Pierce armor, 8 plus 1 against 6 plus 1. That's definitely a pretty big difference, and exactly what means. Rather, it means that MBL has lost yet again all his navy, and he is having just a few boats in here. I'm kind of thinking that he's not really interested in returning back to the water, and he will be probably switching into the full land here. So far, he doesn't seem to have any kind of signs of barracks or whatever, just building yet another town center to blow himself up. He's having 68 villagers, which is definitely not enough, but looking how sniper is also having 68. 79, 74 for the rest of NCs, whereas bullet is having 95. That's quite a lot extra above NCs, and he's definitely doing a pretty good job with the slinging here to Spaden. And let's see if Spaden can actually make some kind of use of that. He definitely is trying to, as he has been trying to switch into the gate here for some potential full-on attack. He's already going to be having two castles and some rams, I would be expecting. And some rams being ready. And oh, here we see a bit of a landing from Andorin, but unfortunately he didn't account for the sling and for the castles here, so this is just going to be yeah, nice attempt, but not really going to finish anything nice. But is he going to finish at least this building? Yeah, he did finish the building, so that's at least some kind of slight victory. But looking at the amount of Mangurais already present, this is pretty much it. And Andorin has to recognize that he won't be having any kind of luck with landing here. He could potentially be landing from the bottom, because it's not really guarded, and this would be pretty surprising. I don't really see any kind of help from purple or even red to scout here. So potentially that would be a pretty clever play. And looking how Andorin has already won the battle on the water on the left, he could definitely see that, and that would be a very nice idea and very surprising to his opponent. Yet another castle being dropped, so that's basically just a waste of resources for Andorin. Not exactly sure why he would even want to make a knight here. But he's at least going to scout what his opponent is doing, and that is going to be valuable for him. But Slunk Mongol, with three castles already in place, is pretty much a big threat, and Andorin has to be worried right now. Because even though he's having pretty much the correct civilizations, the Huns with paladins, against all those Mangurais, I'm not exactly sure if he's going to be ready for the early attack that is coming this way. Yeah, already Trebuchet trying to take down the wall, even though the second row is already in place. But looking at somewhere else, very nicely positioned castle by Beta to control the straight here. And same could be said for Bullet, who is at least trying to place a bit of a town center, but unfortunately for him, it's not going to be as easy. And well, I'm just waiting for the Kalon Galleons. They are definitely going to wreck all the economies and all the players of their opposing team. Nice control of this gold mine, of course. An Imperial Age coming for Andorin, so he will be in pretty good spot to defend against the red player, but so far he needs to be quite faster, because if he isn't, well, he's going to be facing quite a bit of problems, because those trebuchets are not something that Andorin can do anything about, and really, this kind of army is pretty strong, especially with those ramps, and I don't really see any kind of knights. Rather, we really see actually a lot of them. But since Andorin is just now in the Imperial Age, the cavaliers are still some ways off. Let's slow it down a bit so that we actually don't get all that much of a lag. And with the Mangonel here, well, that could be enough. But looking how he's having just 7 range, and 7 range is for Mangurais as well. Yeah, you can kinda guess where this is going, and all the reinforcements from Pedro are absolutely needed to get rid of at least all those trebuchets here. Pretty good range with the 10, so they could be actually shooting at all those trebuchets without all that much of a problem, but they are also having pretty decent pierce armor, as you can see, 8. So not all that easy, and Andurin will be needing all the help that he can get, because those Mangonels are not going to be enough in here. Just waiting for the Cavaliers and Plate Barden armor to be finished with Bait advancing into Imperial Age as well, so we could be potentially expecting another land aggression on the right side as well, with Bait trying to do something about this opponent sniper. So Andorin is being broken through yet again, so that's, you know, yet another row of walls being broken through, and he's actually having quite a lot of problems, but with the Cavaliers in, he could be in a pretty sweet spot, and could be able to defend, but really, I'm not all that optimistic because of the sling here. Need to check if maybe somebody's, Petr has started slinging into Andorin, so that's at least something, but still, you can see that bullet has already slung a double of that amount, and that's definitely going to make quite a huge difference in here. Yep, not even those boats can really help. They can potentially help with the reinforcements, so they could, or rather, they should definitely stay. And Andorin is doing a pretty good job with the defense in here. Those trebuchets, though, are a pretty huge problem. And he needs something to get rid of those. He needs some cannon galleon. Some cannon galleon help from Pedro would be really going a long way. And with Pardins coming in, well, actually, it might not be all that needed, because right now the amount of cavalry is pretty great, and the army from Spaden is not as big. But looking at very nice positioning of him, Andorin would pretty much do a correct job. Oh yeah, Mangonel shots. I was thinking about actually deleting the walls here so that he could actually surround it all that much more. But with that nice positioning and the Mangonels in here, that did the job as well. And right now this is going to be the end of Spaden's attack. So he will be forced to switch to something else. This is pretty much dealt with. There's no reason to stay here. So let's have a look somewhere else, and that's only at the bottom. With Sniper having a bit of a boat here, Borgal is just trying to control what his opponent is doing and seeing that he's building yet another market. Yet another market is pretty much the first one, I think. Well, this is going to be it, and so far it seems like that Yellow together with Blue are having a pretty nice stranglehold on Teal. And they're really not sure how Teal hopes to advance onto its opponent's island. He's rebuilding in here, so it seems like that this choke point and this these shallows are going to be the ones that they will that he will want to traverse. The siege workshop being built and two castles in here. And that definitely means that this is the correct moment and place for Sniper to build his own castles. As he's Pongo, the same as Spaden, he should be having an easier time defending against his opponent. But I'm kinda interested why Beta is going for all those plume touches, as I would be maybe expecting that Eagle Warriors could be slightly better, but that's definitely an option for a bit later, and right now he hopes that he can make something happen with all those archers. On the left we also see a lot of blinking on the minimap for the red player, who is under attack of all those galleons and whatnot from Pedro, basically all the sides in here. And well, this is very nicely placed castle for Spaden, as obviously it's covering the gold, which is going to be quite important for the next game. In the middle we see a bit of a battle between all those Mangurais and quite a lot of galleons from Pedro, without any kind of support by Andorin, but he was able to build the castle, which is very important, as it's another layer of defense, and also he has been able to secure this stone for him, for yet another row of castles. Right now there's doors open, so is Andorin actually going to use it? Finally, right now he is. Yeah, no defense for Spaden, and this is going to be just some kind of raiding spree before anything happens for Spaden in the defense, which is definitely not really all that clever, I would say. And I would be expecting him to be building a wall here and gate, at least attempting to do so, even though it's going to be hard. And yeah, finally we see the elite cannon galleons in here, and that's pretty much going to be the end of these castles. And a big problem for Spaden, because he is having all three castles or four castles in water range, and yeah, he's definitely going to pay for it right now. Yeah, 11 range, 15 range, that's definitely very nicely in range, and if he can support with enough, I don't know, some kind of Mangonels or other onagers and enough paladins, he could be in a pretty good spot to get rid of Spaden altogether. Some stables also being prepared on Sniper's Island, just in case that Sniper is under some kind of heavy attack from his opponent MBL, which is definitely seeming like some kind of idea from him, but look at how he actually doesn't have a way through. Well, he's attempted to do so on the left, but it's going to be quite hard against all those Magurais, but really, looking at the amount of boats here, both the Galleons and the Elite Cannon Galleons, I'm not exactly expecting that it should be all that much of a problem. Well, this will be so sweet for us on Azure Shot. Fortified both party and tactics for Sniper right now. I'm still waiting if he has some kind of siege workshop somewhere. Yeah, he's built them finally. So that could be helpful. But at the same time, you can see that Baiten has been able to push through. And that's actually a bit of a problem. Oh, that's going to disrupt the trade route here. I was just going to see if there's actually any kind of wall between Pedro and Yellow, and there actually isn't. And I would be thinking that Beta would be doing the best job if he actually just laying on, went in, and tried to disrupt Pedro altogether. Well, that would be quite heavy, and it seems like that it could be happening exactly right now. Well, this is going to be tough. Andorin is having a bit of paladins here, so he has rebuilt, or rather built those tables at exactly the right moment, because it's definitely going to be needed. But looking at the sheer amount of Beta's blunt archers, very nice feat of the stable, because they needed to deny any kind of choke point for those archers to hide in. Well, this is definitely going to cost quite a lot of resources for NCs, and might be a bit hard to deal with, but they should be managing without all that much of a trouble in the long run. But still, the way is open, and all the throngs of those blunt archers are still trickling in, and they are pretty much in huge numbers, and I'm not exactly sure if Aiden, or rather, if Sniper together with Pedro and Andorin are exactly ready for this. Yeah, they're able to kill them, but they are basically just dividing the army and denying any kind of extra reinforcements to deal with this. Yeah, so I definitely think that Sniper needs to be switching into some kind of onages, but let's have a look on the left how Andorin is doing against Baiden. So far it doesn't seem like that he's doing all that well. Elite Cannon Galleons are unfortunately not helping with anything, not with the castles, but this castle should be coming down to this trebuchet sometime soon. But I wouldn't really be all that positive about it, because it seems like that Andorin was concentrating on the right side all that much, and oh well, there's actually a way through, what the hell? That wasn't very nicely done by Andorin, so that's definitely a big problem, because right now he's going to get totally wrecked. He's going to totally right, because he doesn't have any kind of army in here. He's having just a few paladins, and that's not going to be enough. He was concentrating on helping his ally on the right side all too much, and he altogether forgot about his own defense, and right now he's going to pay for it quite immensely, because this amount of Mangurais is just a bit too much for any kind of, yeah, for any kind of Mangonel shot, or any kind of how to call it, a last moment paladin's charge to actually make something about it. Yeah, this is a pretty hard situation for him, and he's just going to get killed absolutely altogether without any kind of receiving help. I would be thinking this might be just it for the game, and even though it's heavily surprising, because NCs were having the upper hand for like majority of it, this is pretty much it, as right now Andorin is losing quite a lot of willies. Even though he's still at 115, this is going to be quite hard for him to defend. And on the right, the situation seems to be more or less contained. I don't really see any kind of problems, or rather any kind of teal army here. Yeah, this is a bit more problematic. And even though Spaden has been switched to the right as well, he doesn't have really any kind of buildings. Just sent flank of Mangurais in here. Yep, this has cost quite a lot to the NC team, and right now they will have to switch to the left as much as they can. Right now I kinda think that all those boats should be switching to the left, because Andorin needs the help quite dearly. He's right now getting absolutely wrecked, without any kind of anything. And, well, all the more reinforcements coming in, and especially with the castle right on the stone here. This is going to allow Spaden to gather all the extra stone and drop yet another castle right in the middle of Andorin's base. And without any kind of support from army of either Sniper or Pedro, because Pedro is right now slinging full time. Yep, this is going to be quite hard to defend, and let's see if somehow NCs can master their strength. Because on the right is definitely not easy. You can also see that Red is switching into the right side. They are trying to find their ways into Sniper's army. Or rather, sniper's base, but they are not really successful so far, and these boats are everything that stands between the full-on attack of RFR into sniper's base. Right now he should be able to rebuild at least the walls, and if he can somehow stabilize this situation, he's having enough castles, so he should be able to deal with MBL just by his own, but so far it doesn't really seem so, and exactly, yep. This is a very nice help, and basically the same that RFRs were doing a bit earlier, and this is exactly what he needs. But look at how Andorians actually not having any kind of paladins, they should be timing this a whole lot better. And he needs to be picking off those siege ramps, obviously. And switching, oh well, this is pretty bad news for Andorin, because once he is switching into Hussars and Light Cavalry, this is basically telling you that he doesn't have the resources, he doesn't have the gold, and well, yeah, you can kind of guess where this is going from there. Quite a lot of food and wood, but not anything extra. And even though Spaden is switching into the Hussars as well, yeah, I'm not exactly sure if this is going to work as well. So it seems almost like NCs are abandoning Andorin's Island. They kinda are. Slightly curious why Spass Sniper actually didn't take care of the siege ramp. It would definitely help and actually delay the attack of all those Mangurais, but well, this is it, and Andorin is just biding his time. He has basically lost everything in there, and is he going to try and land? He still has the transport ship, so he definitely could. Even a few boats at the bottom. But not much else than that, and that's quite a lot of boats all around for Pedro. So yeah, kinda interesting, and I would be liking him to have quite a lot more Canon Galleons and trying to take down the castles actually, which is so far not happening at all, and it's really curious why not. He's just using the Canon Galleons into villages. It's absolutely useless and definitely not helping in the attempts to push through or even defend Sniper's base here. So he's being prepared for some kind of full-on assault, but with the Mangurais in here, you should be getting rid of all those gems without all that much of a problem. So far not really paying enough attention, it seems though. And it's kinda curious, because right now, deal is through, and this could be quite deadly army, because obviously the amount of plumed archers here, together with the support of all the sieges coming in, well, that's pretty strong indeed. On the left, it seems like that this road has been basically plucked in. But on the right side, this is a big problem, and I'm really curious why we don't see any kind of onages from snipers. Definitely he's Mongol, so he could be having some nice siege, but he's not using them at all, and he definitely needs them against this huge amount of plumed archers. If he could build them, they could definitely help, and it would be a very nice army for him. Reason probably going to be because he doesn't have enough gold for even the production of Mangurais. You can see that he's losing a lot of them, even though he's fighting on the hill. And yep, right now you can see that Spaden is also helping and trying to support the very strong attack by Beta. Fortunately, it seems like that's basically the problem the whole game for NCs. They are just not communicating well, it seems, as really, they are not coordinating at all. Andorin has just sent everything in after the sniper has lost half his army, and exactly at the moment when sniper was actually retreating back, so that was not idle at all, and well, yeah, this is not the way that you can actually win games. On the left though, Andorin seems to be doing a pretty good job of finally recuperating with sniper's help, at least a bit. And he has actually also deleted the castle with the help of Pedro, or yeah, of Pedro. And if he can somehow keep Spaden busy just on this side, finally making use of those Canon Galleons into some kind of buildings, well, he could definitely do a bit better with the castle. He could be in a situation that where he could actually control his opponent, which would be quite valuable, and yeah, would allow Andorin to basically rebuild exactly as he needs to, because right now he's just at 686 villagers, and if he could drop into something better, well, that would help quite a lot. On the right though, that's a big problem, because those plantages together with Mangurais from RFR have conquered the island, rather the hill, so they are having an extra bonus into attack, and they have already killed the castle, and yet another castle is going to be dropped in just a matter of moments, and sniper will be left with just one, which is definitely not enough, and I don't see any kind of extra stone in here, so it should be quite expensive for him to buy. Yeah, so that's a big problem. That's a big problem right now for Sniper, because he will be forced to switch into something else if he wants to somehow make his game count. Yeah, this was a very nice delete, basically denying the sweet spot for here. And if those Mangurais can actually kill all those trebuchets, they could be buying all the extra time for Andorin to do something about all those mutages, but this is very nicely played by MBL, as he's retreating to the choke points here and limiting the room that the opponents could be getting at all of those. So castle down, which is a pretty huge victory right now for Pedro and his team. And if he can, oh yeah, he can see the switch into barracks here. This is probably going to be switch into all those pikemen against paladins, which is definitely a good idea and could be a huge problem for NCs, as they don't really seem to be having all that much of an army that could be dealing with that. Skirmishes though are a pretty good idea from Andorin. They will definitely be helping against all those fruit arches and whatnot. And I'm just really waiting for all those on edges in here. But looking how it's probably hard for the for either sniper or anybody from his team to amass enough gold for them. This is not happening so far, but I really think proper micro, they will be super useful, especially looking how Beta is using all those choke points to basically limit the amount of army that is attacking his. And really, that would be quite nice combo and would disrupt the play of MBL altogether. Finishing with the wall, but probably not going to finish altogether, especially with all those pikemen trickling in. And on the left, it seems like that Andorin is pretty much safe, so he's not really having all that much of a fight here. And yeah, you can see that Spaden is also not having all that many resources, and I mean just a huge amount of hussars, which is not all that useful. Definitely less useful than Mangudais. We don't see any kind of threat for RFRs, because obviously NC Pedro is patrolling quite well, trying to control the water as much as he can. This is also the point in the game where he could be the deciding point. Yeah, yet another point in there, sorry. But really, this is also quite important for the development, because obviously the goal that NCs are getting is quite important for paladins and literally anything that they are building, and that makes quite a huge difference. It basically allows sniper to build Mangurai still, whereas his opponent Spaden is forced to switch into full-on hussars because he doesn't have any kind of gold altogether. Let's just switch into Spaden. Well, he does have enough gold, but he's probably just selling it, I would be guessing, because there's not going to be any kind of substantial trade. They are probably trying to make something happen on the trade, but it's not really going to be all that successful, because if they can't control the map on the water, yeah, this is pretty much it. In the middle though, there is a pretty important attack by Spaden, who is trying to break through into Pedro, which is definitely a great idea. Since Pedro is the one who is slinging and basically keeping his allies alive, both Andorin and Sniper, this would be a huge disruption of the army. And I kind of think this is a bit of a last Hail Mary, because if he cannot do anything substantial in here, he's going to lose the last amount of Mangurais that he has. And yeah, he doesn't have all that much gold. Right now he does, but not really for much longer. As yet again, I have to stress this important point. Without trade, NCs are having a huge advantage because they do have a trade. So, broken through, but with the army at the right spot, yeah, this is going to be pretty much easy, I would be thinking, with all those Mangurais in here. But they definitely need to be careful, and Mangurais should be running a bit further, I would be thinking. But with the support from the water, from the galleys, yeah, you can see that red is just a pretty horrible choke point, and he will be losing absolutely everything that he basically already has. He doesn't have all that much more army left. And he's definitely losing in here, because Andorin is controlling this position quite nicely with the help from Sniper, and yeah, there's not going to be anything that Spaden can do to push through here. Even though he's sending throngs of armies in, this is not going to be enough, and if we see some kind of extra help from Pedro here, he's trying to rebuild the wall, but not really all that successfully. And this could actually be a bit of a problem. I might have been a bit too hasty, because I was kinda expecting that Andorin, together with Sniper, would be sending a bit more reinforcements, but they aren't. And well, Pedro definitely did a good job with building docks, as he will be needed to build as many boats in here as he can. Also, pretty important that deal is switching on the left as well, trying to rebuild and push through. So this is going to be quite important battle. If somehow RFRs are able to push through, this could be a huge problem for NCs. But I'm not really all that optimistic about it, even though they are sitting quite a lot of units here and NCs are not having enough. All these galleons are pretty much the nice unit here, and they will be having quite a huge impact on the reinforcements. So if they can stop the reinforcements, this is basically going to be it, as it's going to be a question of time before NCs are able to defend. And if the castle is going to be up, yep, this might be it. big problem because they are right in the middle of the trade, so that's a huge problem for NCs right now, but probably not for much longer. And with all those Plumtaches coming in, and especially all those skirmishes, yeah, this is pretty much going to be goodbye Plumtaches, and yeah, you are going to be toast. It's also important to notice that Beta is not really concentrating on those villages building the castle, which is a huge mistake in my opinion. Right now he finally is, so yeah, he definitely should have concentrated on that a lot sooner. Because without the castle, there is still some kind of chance, but once the castle is up, it's pretty much easily defended and RFRs will have to retreat, and they will be pretty much toast. So yeah, castle is here, so goodbye attack, and this is pretty much battle defended, and it might be just resulting into pure GG. And even though the castle has been dropped right now, it did deal some extra damage, and with the extra reinforcements coming in from both Sniper and Andorin, well, this is a pretty huge battle. And yeah, here we see the GGs, and NCs are tying the match at 2-2. Very nice game, and crazy battle at the very end. Very nice attempt by RFRs, who basically recognize that they need to make, or rather mount, some one last strong push, and if it did pay off, it actually could have won them the game, because they would have deleted NC Pedro, who was slinging both those allies, keeping him alive and disrupting the trade route. But since it didn't work out, nicely defended by NCs, yeah, this is pretty much it, as without gold, you are not going to live long in the later Imperial Age. Well, nice game indeed. So let's have a look at the achievements. And yeah, exactly as Europe is saying. Considering that Beta actually succeeded with double bore steal from Sniper at the very early game, that's definitely some feat for NCs to come back from that. Spaden the MVP, but he was quite heavily slung. Unfortunately for RFRs, it didn't really matter all that much, or it really mattered. He was able to kill Andorin quite nicely, but unfortunately not fully. And since NCs were cooperating a bit better than RFRs, even though there were definitely times where the communication could have been better, well, NCs are emerging victorious. Well, that's a pretty big sling in here from both of them, from both Bullet and Pedro. And very nice advance into Imperial Age. It also made quite a lot of difference, those Galleons and Elite Cannon Galleons from Pedro, they were making quite a lot of difference in there. Alright then, GG.